1-2 pitch, and Pika lines that second baseman. It's going to scoot underneath the glove of Kelly, and it's going to go into right field. It's a base hit. They'll wave the runner around from third base as well. In further, Pika with a ball that's hit to right field. They score two, and it's 2-0. The Bulldogs strike first. As Meyer delivers a 3-2 pitch, and that ball is lined into right center field. It's a base hit. They'll score two. Scoring from second base all the way is going to be the runner, Growl. Kishman goes to third, trying to advance on a throw that got by the third baseman, and she's going to be throwing out there. Into second base is Shaw with a base hit and two RBIs. The Eagles get the first out of the inning, but the Bulldogs now lead 6-0. 1-1 pitch, Schubert reaches out for it, slaps it into right field, it's a base hit. Rourke throws it into the infield, it's caught there as it rolls to the catcher can, but it's a base hit for Schubert. She has three hits, drives in her second run of the night, and now 15-2 is the score. And Shohorn whips this into center field, that's a base hit. Knocked down by the center fielder, Curry, it scoots away. Werger scores, Pika will score from third base, the throw comes into the infield by the pitcher Werger, and because of that, Shohorn goes to second base. It's a base hit, it's two RBIs, and the Bulldogs continuing to pound the softball. It is now 21-2 here in the top of the fifth inning. 1-2 pitch, swinging right through it, there is Can. It is strikeout number 9 recorded by Habrichter, and that does it for Clayton Ridge in the bottom of the fifth inning. They score 2 runs, they do it on 3 hits, they leave a runner. But MFL Marmac erupted for 7 in the first inning. They slam the door with 12 runs in the top of the fifth inning, and the Bulldogs win their season opener 22-4.
The best baseball and softball action is on KETR AM and FM.